Hi, I'm Brent Schooley, and I'm going to show you how to use a popular Swift web framework called Vapor. To get started, head over to Vapor's website at vapor.codes and click on the install button. The first thing you'll need is Swift 3. If you're on macOS, all you need to do is install Xcode 8. There's also some manual instructions on this page, but this is the easiest way to go. If you're on Linux, you'll want to be on Ubuntu, and Vapor's again made it super simple to get started. Just run this curl command and they'll install Swift 3 for you. Once you have Swift 3, go to the Install toolbox and run this curl command in your terminal, and that will set up Vapor's command line interface called Vapor Toolbox. Once you have everything installed, you can run Vapor new in the name of a project. We'll say Hello World here to create a new Vapor project. Then we'll change directories into our new project and run Vapor build to fetch the dependencies and build the project using Swift Package Manager. Once that's complete, we'll use Vapor's run serve command to fire up a server on localhost at port 8080. And if we visit that in the browser, you'll find that it works. All right, let's open this up in a text editor and see what's going on. In the sources folder, you'll find a file called main.swift. There's also a bunch of other boilerplate code that you might use in the creation of a REST API. We're not going to need that for this tutorial, so let's just get rid of it so that it doesn't distract us. For our first iteration of Hello World, we'll create a get route for a request to /hello. And in that route, we'll simply return a string that says hello world to render out to the browser. Heading back to the terminal, we'll build the application. And then we'll run the server again using Vapor run serve. This time in the browser, we'll visit localhost port 8080 /hello. And there we see the hello world greeting. For our second iteration of hello world, we'll need to work with views and layouts. The base.leaf layout includes a couple of sections that we can fill in from our view that we'll create, namely the head and the body of the web page. Create a new view file inside of views called hello.leaf. We'll extend from the base layout so that we get those portions of the view to fill in, and then we'll begin by exporting the head section from our view. This will replace the head section inside of base.leaf, and we will add a title to the page that says Hello from Vapor. Next, we'll export the body section to fill in the main portion of the web page. And in here, we're going to allow the person that visits /hello to pass in their name as a parameter, and we'll display it inside of an h1 tag. Now let's head back to main.swift and remove the code in our existing hello route so that we can greet our person by name. We'll fetch the name out of the request.data dictionary that includes all of the parameters that were passed in either by query string or JSON or post data. And we'll grab the string representation of the name parameter. If it doesn't exist, we'll set their name simply to stranger. Next, we'll use the droplet to create a view named hello. Remember, we created our view at hello.leaf. Views can receive parameters, and you'll note that our view took in a parameter named name. So we'll pass in name, and we'll give it the value that we fetched out of the request data. Now let's head back to the terminal and run Vapor build again to build the project. And once that's complete, let's run Vapor run serve once again to start up that server on localhost port 8080. In the browser, if we visit /hello, we'll see the hello stranger greeting since we haven't passed in a name. And if instead we pass in a name, let's say Brent in this case, and run that again, we'll see the greeting says hello Brent. If you'd like to learn more about using Vapor, head over to bit.ly/twiliovapor, where you'll find a handful of blog posts and videos to help you get started.